Good evening, everyone. Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
This is about Wonder Women. Let me make you well aware that when Kelly told me that I was going to do this, this was a while ago. Last night was the first time we spoke about it. I said, well, what am I supposed to do? What do you want me to say? She said, well, they said that up to 10 minutes. So my Wonder Woman and I agreed that we were not going to take all of our 10 minutes. And I'm glad that some people did drift back into childhood, and I have a number of Wonder Women in my family, but this is about Kelly tonight. It's one short story that sticks in my mind. I think she was about 6 years old, and she was being babysitted by her uncle, who was maybe 15 or 20 years her senior. And back in the day when it was okay to spank children, and it still is for me. However, Kelly was due for a spanking. And her uncle, who was 15 to 20 years her senior, when he proceeded to spank her, Kelly said to him, do you want to talk about this first? So we knew from that point it was something going on with her when she was trying to bargain with someone that was her senior. But as the second honoree said, I believe, I thought about this. I said, often when I attend events like this and you hear these long bios and all of that, more times than not, my question is, who is the person that's standing behind that bio? Because on paper it can look good, but if you're not walking the walk that that paper is reading, then it's all for naught. So I thought about with Kelly. And I thought about it. It's really not important about her accomplishments, her master's degree, the fact that she's an elected official, she's a divorced mom of a 15-year-old son. All of those things are irrelevant if you're not committed to the cause. So it's with great pride that I have watched this little 6-year-old that wanted to negotiate a spanking evolve into a very strong, dedicated, committed social justice fighting and on the front line of all of our social issues. Man, woman, children, and everything. You'll find her at Lathrop Village as the mayor pro tip. You will find her up in Lansing testifying about a number of issues that are relevant to women, men, and children. So without further ado, I would like to introduce you to the Garrett family's Wonder Woman, my niece, Mayor Pro Tem of Lathrop Village, Kelly Garrett.
When I got the award, because I said, me, a Wonder Woman, because I'm thinking about, my sister came in and surprised me, by the way, tonight from Atlanta, Georgia. So I was thinking about this, and I'm like, you know, I used to dress up like Wonder Woman for absolutely no reason. No one really knew that, but I just felt like it, because that's who I am. You know, so I was thinking about it, and my friends were calling me and telling me that they were happy to hear that. And they're like, we know that you're a Wonder Woman. And I said, I keep going in the closet, I keep spinning around, nothing is happening. But I must say that I did write a speech out, and if anyone really knows me, knows that I don't do well with reading speeches because I totally screw it up. So I'm just going to go off the cuff for 2 minutes. I guess I want to say thank you. No, it's just okay. I'm not doing that yet. So one thing that I've been listening to everybody is what you're doing for your community. And I think that that's very important. But the one thing that I'm passionate about is what we're doing for girls, what we're doing for young women. And I have found my passion that that's what it is. And it's not so much that I need to be a mentor. I don't need to be a role model. What I need to do is demonstrate to young women and women what it means to be a woman. I don't need to tell them, I need to show them. And I will say a quick story. I am an instructor for Barazan Modeling School. Anybody remember that?
Yes.
Okay. So we have to teach etiquette. And I'm teaching and I'm talking, and one of the students comes up to me and she says, "You are so elegant." And I'm thinking to myself, me? Elegant? I think of, you know, Nancy Wilson, elegant. I think of Diane Carroll, elegant. Me? Elegant? But if I'm the only person that's shown her what it is to sit down, to actually demonstrate to her what it is to be a woman, how would she know this? So my passion is to show you how to be a woman. It's my passion to show you how to have integrity, how to have a good character. And I was thinking, how many minutes do I have now? Oh, okay. I'm done?
No. Nah, you're not done.
Yeah, okay. So, I'll say this really fast. I was thinking, what would I say to myself, or what would I say to Kelly Garrett 2010 and 5 years ago? The one thing I would tell her is to stay in, keep your integrity, never compromise. Make sure that you have such a good character that if someone did talk about you, no one will believe you because your character is so impeccable. And then I would also say, make sure that you love everybody unconditionally. It doesn't matter if someone likes you or not, because it's not your job to make them like you. The only thing that is your job is to love unconditionally, no matter what the race is, no matter what the gender is, no matter what the sexual orientation is. Love unconditionally. I thank you so much for this award.